Hi friends, this is Solid Information Channel. Welcome you all to this channel. Please subscribe and press the bell icon. I was speaking about Genghis Khan's early life and his conquests in my previous video. The video's name is Brilliance of a Mighty Warrior, Brutal Brilliance of a Mighty Warrior, Genghis Khan. So in order to see about his early life and how he went around the Great Wall of China and conquered Beijing, kindly go and watch the previous video. In this video, I am going to continue after his conquest of Beijing. So after he conquered Beijing, he did not stop. He wanted to expand his empire, also make Mongolians' lifestyle a better one. So what he wanted to do is he wanted to settle down and start a trading capital at Karakoram. So at Karakoram, he settled down and he started to build it like a capital, and he wanted to trade with Europe and Persia. So he had sent few ambassadors to Persia in order to expand his commerce and trade. So what happened is, one fine day, a messenger carried a gift from Persia to Genghis Khan, and it was nothing but an ambassador's head which was slaughtered by Persians. So what do you think he would do? He became very furious and he sent an army to Persia, and Persia was burned down into ashes. Further, Genghis Khan did not stop. He wanted to even expand his conquests in China. In 1227, Genghis Khan died, but he made his first son as the next Khan, and he was also not a small one. He conquered as far as Russia and Poland. So by the time, that is by 1227, Mongolia was of 4 times the size of Alexander's empire and 2 times the size of Roman empire. Even his son did not stop. He doubled the size of Genghis Khan's empire. But in 1242, his son too passed away, and therefore Europe was spared the Mongol terror. And this was about the great Mongolian empire. After a century, this empire started to decline. But even today, when we talk about Genghis Khan, it is very horrifying that he had made such conquests and Mongolians were so brutal. And do you know one thing? Genghis Khan, when he died, he made sure that his tomb should not be identified by anyone. So whoever had gone to Genghis Khan's funeral were slaughtered, were executed. So even now, no one knows where Genghis Khan's tomb is. So this is one thing. And it seems that Genghis Khan took advice from some saints and monks about how to become eternal, how to gain the eternal life. But he did not get a solution. But he found his own solution. Even today, studies tell that one in every 200 people live on earth can have a trace of genital lineage back to Genghis Khan. Then you can imagine what legend he has created. And it seems that he had more than 500 wives, as I told earlier in my previous video. When there was a war between two tribes or two rulers back then, in the areas surrounding Mongolia and Mongolia, they used to just take away the first lady of the tribe which loses. So thus, Genghis Khan had lots of wives, and therefore this type of legend he has created. He has found a way to lead an eternal life. That's what I can say. So this is about Genghis Khan's great empire, the Mongolian Empire. I would like to share information about Alexander the Great, Ashoka the Great. I would meet you in my next videos. Kindly subscribe and press the bell icon. See you. Bye-bye.